Hi there, Kathy Shea with another wonderful piece of information for all you childbearing women. Had a call today from one of my beautiful therapists out there in the world, and she just found out she's pregnant. And of course, with that comes the resultant shift in her inner ecology, particularly her bowel. She is constipated. Now, this young lady has a history of constipation, so it's remarkably worse now, as an aside. So let's talk about this bowel, which makes its own hormones, perhaps you know that or not, and this shift in the endocrine system that happens when a woman conceives. So these are not separate. This is one big pot of soup, hormonal soup, I'll call it. So the bowel is responding to the shift in her endocrine activity after conception. So the question is it safe for her to have colonics? So we're going to talk about the anatomy of the pelvic floor as it's associated with the neuroendocrine activity, which means the nervous system and chemical activity that is referring from the opening of the rectum, opening of the urethra for bladder control, and the opening of the vagina that leads to the cervix and the uterus, of course. These are all in the same bowl, and they're all innervated through many of the same nerve pathways. So giving a woman a colonic in her first trimester could be dangerous. And the reason is 70% of first-time conceptions in the United States of America are lost. So we have a very interesting statistic there that speaks to the delicacy of this first trimester. Okay, this tiny little embryo right now in her body is the size of a lentil. It is implanting into the wall of her uterus and wanting to attach itself very, very strongly to that uterine wall and be fed by that blood that will make a placenta ultimately. So it's a very delicate time, this first trimester, as this embryo does the implantation, puts down roots, so to speak, and begins to grow and hopefully stay attached. So we don't want to do anything to disturb this possibility of attachment to the uterine wall. And introducing a large tube speculum, which is quite a strong width of diameter versus the tip of an enema, which is much thinner, could in fact stimulate those nerves and cause a spontaneous loss of that life. So we recommended that she do her enemas as needed, half a bag, maybe just one quart of water to keep the bowel moving so she doesn't get uncomfortable and get backed up. And then if there's no complication in the second trimester, which means no cramping, no spotting, no blood in her vaginal area, and the conceptus is now fully attached and strong, it may be safe for her at that time to go ahead and have colonics if needed. Personally, I would rather do the enema to be on the safe side throughout the entire pregnancy. Let's talk about that last trimester, okay? These nerves that might be stimulated by a speculum being inserted into the rectum could stimulate a premature labor in the third trimester. So we don't want to disturb that full capacity for gestation to 9 months with that tiny little body that's growing and being nurtured by the mother and the father. So we talked to her about both of them putting their hands on her uterus every night before they go to sleep, speaking to this little being that they've invited in, inviting that child to be strong and know that this child is safe, we're going to take care of you. Making this connection with this being early in the conception time will make her pregnancy a lot gentler. So thank you for watching, and all the best to all you new mamas and papas out there.